And I will ask now Dr. Muhammad Saad to tell us about the study sources for exam and also to tell us about the MCQ guidelines. And if, of course, if anyone wants to comment, he can comment after Dr. Muhammad. The mic is you, Dr. Muhammad.
Thank you, Dr. Ajit. Do you hear me overall? My voice is clear.
Yeah.
My voice.
Yeah, your voice is clear, Dr. Muhammad.
Yes, okay. First, I want to thank Dr. Waleed. Thank you for your trust and give me the chance to share my experience. And I am so happy to talk to my colleagues about the study sources and MCQ guidelines. The study sources, best study sources for the exams is variable from one to another. I will show my point of view, and anyone have the another source to show it is not eligible to, not obligatory to follow my route or my study sources. I want to classify our studying to three part or three phases. You have a reading phase and a study phase and exam phase. This circles, the large circle for reading phase, you can read anything and from textbook as you want, but in the study phase you must be concentrated in smart and small sources, and when you go for exam phase, you must have a very little and smart source to give all the knowledge at the night of the exam. The reading phase, you can read from any textbook. I consider Kaniski as a textbook, and American Academy of Ophthalmology also a textbook, Yanov also a textbook. Read from any source you want. Build your knowledge as you want. The Kaniski have edition 7 and 8 edition, and I recommend the last edition have many updates in different categories. And you read from any source you want for the exam and build your knowledge as you want. But when you go for studying phase, you must concentrate and search about small and summarized source, like training in ophthalmology. This is my best source for reading. And the Wells I manual give you a different methods and a different informations about differential diagnosis. Also, my love book, Oxford Handbook of Ophthalmology. This is a very, very, very useful and very smart source for studying and for the exam also. You must make your reference when you study from Oxford Handbook of Ophthalmology. Oxford Handbook of Ophthalmology is a very, very summarized source. You can read from it and mark and make your reference, as this is a picture from my Oxford Handbook. When I read about lattice degeneration, for example, I write in front of it Kaniski 8, page 687, A689. This is a picture for lattice degeneration. I think Kaniski is a very illustrative source. The pictures in Kaniski is very good, and I give references for my information in Oxford Handbook related to Kaniski as a picture source or a source. The exam phase, when we enter in the exam phase, you must be concentrate. You will enter MCQ exam or problem solving exam or you will admit for third part exam in Glasgow. If you enter the MCQ exam, the best study source after that, after Oxford Handbook of Ophthalmology, is a review question in ophthalmology of Kenneth Wright. This is a useful book containing multiple MCQs with detailed answers. I think this is a good source for reviewing the MCQs. Also, Provision Series 5. This is the MCQ of American Academy of Ophthalmology, and I consider it also a very good source to train yourself about MCQs. Also, the problem solving, if you prepare yourself to study the problem for problem solving exam, you must consider general medicine. General medicine is a big trouble for many colleagues because the general medicine not related to our career or our ophthalmology teams, but Dr. Waleed Badr Zafarian have a very smart source, internal and emergency medicine, and available in the Facebook group. You can download and print it. It's very smart and contain all information about internal and emergency medicine that you need in the exam. And you must concentrate on this because if you don't have if you don't pass the general medicine questions in the problem solving exam, you can't pass the overall exam. Also, Oxford Handbook of Ophthalmology with references, and the last book and the new book is Case Reviews in Ophthalmology. Case Reviews in Ophthalmology give you a detail about the training about the problem solving style. This is from the book, really, a 3 years old boy is brought to your office because of a droopy eyelid. His mother states that his right eye has always looked small. What is the diagnosis and the possible etiologies? What to look for on exam to determine the etiology? What are the characteristic findings of congenital myogenic ptosis? What is the treatment of congenital myogenic ptosis? What is the prognosis? This is the style of this book, and I think it's useful. Case reviews in ophthalmology. It's useful to prepare yourself for the problem solving exam. The third part of Glasgow exam, the best study source from my point of view is Oxford Handbook with reference, I said before. And the FRCS Ophthalmology Cookbook is a very nice book and team multiple scenarios and give you an idea about oral and clinical exam. Also, Dr. Al-Ghunaymi Clinical Examination Notes. This is a very useful notes for clinical examination techniques and the clinical examination tips. And you must consider it from now, not only before the exam, as it is contained a lot of valuable information. Also, as regarding the FRCS of ophthalmology quotes, this is apart from a snapshot from the book regarding anterior segment, common viva, and the case scenarios. Multiple details give you a scenario about a young adult with spherical bullous keratopathy in corneal graft and avenge contact lens. What could be the cause and indication for keratopathy, trauma, keratoconus, corneal dystrophy? How will you manage? This is the apart from the book. You can read and revise your knowledge to be prepared for the third part exam of FRCS. Guidelines for solving MCQs. I considered this a seven tips or a seven guidelines. You must have a good preparation. You must read the questions carefully. Eliminate incorrect answers. Don't lose your time and move on hand and return. Trust yourself and train yourself. This seven guidelines, the good preparation, you have a good preparation for the exam. I consider the good preparation have a 50% of success. Success questions which of following mutation is associated with an IREDIA, A, B, C, or D. If you don't have the genetic basis of an IREDIA, you can't solve these questions. You must have a very good background and a very good knowledge to answer such questions. You must build your knowledge and you must know about some details. Of course, the answer for these questions is A. PAX6 gene is the mutation in this gene causing an IREDIA. You must have the knowledge for this. If you don't have, you can't answer. Also, the second guideline for solving MCQs is read carefully. You must read the question carefully. In such a question, which one of the following ocular or systemic conditions is not associated with obturbinitis? Consistinuria, amyloid, microcornea, minimal schizane. If you don't notice the word not, you will be confused in the exam. Which one of the following ocular or systemic condition is not associated with ectopics? If you concentrate and read not carefully, you will suspect homocystinuria associated with ectovirentis, amyloidias associated with ectovirentis, Guillain-Barré is associated with ectovirentis, so not is the microcornea. Microcornea not associated with ectovirentis. You must read the question carefully. The third point or the third guideline for solving MCQ from my point of view, eliminate the incorrect answers. Eliminate options you know to be incorrect. In such a question, in acute diacrylocystitis, a topical antibiotic without systemic antibiotic should be prescribed. Cool compresses are applied to the medial cancers. Diagnostic probing may be a therapeutic in adults. Most adults will need a DCR for correction of outflow obstruction. You must eliminate the incorrect answer. I think diagnostic probing is a big wrong diagnostic probing for acute diacrylocystitis is not an option. And also, topical antibiotic without systemic antibiotic should be prescribed, not should. He described this is wrong also. Cold compresses not have a rule by exclusion. The correct answer, the most adult will need a DCR for correction of outflow obstruction. By elimination of incorrect answer, we can answer the MCQs. Also, the fourth guideline, don't lose your time. You must concentrate when you're answering. Don't speed. Don't lose your time. Trust self. You must have keep calm and trust yourself. Trust yourself. able to answer the question in a very little time. Thank you for your attention, and thank you for the chance to give my point of view. And any questions? Any other comments or questions?
Okay. Thank you, Dr. Muhammad, for your wonderful presentation.
You're welcome, Dr. Ali.
I want just to add one more comment. The best study source is your clinic. Be sure about this. Before any book, before studying, the best study source is your clinic, especially in FRCS exam. Maybe in traditional exams, you just go for books and go for exam and pass. But this is not the way in FRCS exam. If you read a lot of books, if you read textbook without a good practice at your clinic, knowing how to deal with patients in the FRCS approach, you will be in a big trouble. So the most important study source is your clinic. The second comment, I want also to add to sources of Dr. Muhammad Saad, the Wong book of Ophthalmology Examination Review by Wong. This is a very useful book. You can read it as a summary after your study. And the most important, in my point of view, of course, the most important study source is Showa site. And also in my point of view, it is so difficult to pass the exam. I speak about the third part, specifically Glasgow. It is so difficult to pass the exam without reading the Showa website. Not all the website, this is a huge website. You have to read about the past candidate experiences, and you have to read about the clinical multi-station exam. So Showa site is of great importance in preparing for FRCS Part 3. This is my
I agree with you, Dr. Waleed. The past experience is very important. I forget to mention it in my presentation, but in the third part, the vast experience of our colleagues is very, very important to passing the part three exam. Thank you.
Okay, thanks, Dr. Muhammad. This is only my additional comments. Dr. Ahmed, you wanted to add something?
Well, I agree, Dr. with you, Dr. Waleed, that the only book is a great book. It is written in the style of the exam. It is one-to-one styled answers and the questions. You can't do without it in any exam in the third part or any clinical or oral exam. So that's how I will talk about it when in my presentation about Edinburgh.
Okay.
Dr.
Hassanin is asking about what is your opinion about ophthalmology case review study. Dr. Hassanin, Dr. Muhammad Saad already illustrated about this, And I think this is a great book. For me, I don't know a great idea about this book, but I trust Dr. Muhammad in his opinion, so you must review this book also. But the main sources, of course, as Dr. Muhammad said, is Kaniski, Wells, Oxford, and I will add ophthalmology examination review by Wong and Showa Sight. And for emergency medicine, and I can't tell an opinion because this is already my notes, but I recommend at least to take a review at my notes. They may help me. Okay, we will move to next part. About MCQ question, already Dr. Muhammad Saad illustrated about it, and it was really very useful advices from him about the guidelines for solving MCQ questions.